Yours. I'll see you, buddy.
Hey, excuse me. Nancy?
Yes?
Hi, my name is Thomas Magnum. I'm a private investigator. Do you have a couple seconds to talk?
What's this about?
Well, I think you may know my client, Oscar Leota.
I'm sorry, I don't know who that is.
Look, just got worried when he didn't show up the other day and wants to make sure that you're safe.
Clearly, I'm fine. If I'd known he'd send a PI after me, I never would have called. If you don't mind, I've got a flight to catch.
Well, you wouldn't have reached out to him, all right, in the first place if you didn't want help. But there are other people out there that could be in danger, and if you know something that could help them, look, I won't tell him your name, all right, if you decide to move forward on this. I promise.
The article said she flew to Hawaii a couple months ago, but you still remember her from just this one interaction.
Well, mostly I remember the man she was traveling with.
She wasn't alone?
No. No, I'd seen the guy before a few times. Going between the Marshall Islands and Hawaii, he's always escorting women dressed in baggy clothes. I think he was using them to smuggle drugs. I thought about reporting it, but after a few months, these women always returned home. They didn't seem like they'd been harmed, and plus, I've got a son. I don't want any trouble. But then I saw Hanani's face in the paper. I said she'd been stabbed to death. I couldn't do nothing. These are the manifests for every flight that I saw the man Hanani was with. His name is Nathan Stollard. I was gonna give those to Mr. Leota.
I'll make sure he gets them, but I have to ask. You were the one who set up the meeting, so why did you back out?
I did go to the park that day. I saw Oscar had gotten there first, but when I got closer, I saw Stollard parked in his car, just watching.
So he was staking out Oscar to see who his contact was.
I felt awful leaving, but Stollard just seems like such a dangerous man. I was afraid he would recognize me.
Do you remember what kind of car he was driving?
I don't remember the make, but it was a blue car. No plates.